Teaching business writing skills. Letters. Business employees routinely spend a lot of time writing letters and memos and sending email messages, instant messages, and text messages. So a routine business correspondence uses emails, letters, memos, reports, and also with mobile communication using instant and text messages. This screenshot shows that 98% of correspondence is carried out through the email, 70% through memos and letters, and 60% is carried out through writing reports. So business correspondence uses letters, memos, emails, text messages. So with this huge amount of choice which is there, how should we decide? What should be the criteria of deciding which means to choose? So it could depend upon the destination where we want to send this message to. It could depend upon the audience we are writing for, who is going to read it, whether these readers are going to be external or internal audience. What would be the channel which we are going to use to send this message across? What is the security of this message which you are using, whether it is private or whether other people will also be able to look at it? And what would be the format? What would be the topic, and whether it allows for any attachments also to be sent along with it? So this is the criteria which is going to help us choose which one of these various types of messages or means of communication to choose from. So since letters are for external correspondence, unlike memos which are for internal correspondence, so they leave your desk. Once you have written the letter, it is going to leave your desk and go to the other company or to the client or to the vendor for which you are writing it. So it is a reflection not only of your own communication abilities, but also a reflection about your own company. Therefore, there is a need that it should look professional and it should be of the highest standard. And unlike memos and unlike other forms of communication, the letters require a reply and they also would be responded to. Okay, you also have to look at the audience for which you are writing. So generally, because letters usually leave your office and they are for external audience, so they are generally for a low-tech audience or for lay audience. These audience could be vendors, they could be clients, they could be stakeholders or stockholders, and so on. So what should be the tone of your letter? This again depends upon who you are writing for, who are your audience or readers. So the tone has to be formal. With the memos, it could be informal because that is for in-company correspondence. But with letters, you have to keep a very formal tone. As these audience are external audience like vendors, clients and customers, etc. Also, you have to relate your tone and your level of formality, informality with the topics. Since these are related to your vendors and to the stakeholders' interests, so you have to use such vocabulary which is easily understood by them. And you have to define your abbreviations and acronyms using parenthetical cases. Also, you have to look at how many attachments and enclosures which you can attach along with the letters. So one good point about letters is that you can attach as many additional documents, put them in the same envelope as where you are putting the letter. Then you can also send complimentary copies for other readers. As regards the complexity and the length of the communication, usually a letter which is sent for business purposes is of one page of text. However, if it is more than one page, then it could go up to two or three pages. However, if it is longer, then you can perhaps abandon the letter format and use a report format. You also have to look at it will take for the letter to reach its destination. What would be the time in which it will be delivered to the reader or to the audience? So this is determined by when you are writing, by the distance at which it has to go, and what is its destination. These days, the courier services are quite quick, quite speedy, so it can be delivered within a day. if the destination is within the same city. Lastly, the letters need to be proofread, and the three-step process of writing should be followed, writing, pre-writing, and rewriting. You have to look for whether the letter is concise enough to ease accessibility of from the readers. It has to be informative, meaning that it should be giving all the information which is required by the reader. It should convey a professional image. Ethics should be followed. In other words, we can say that it should be perfect as far as the writing, as far as the content is concerned, because it is a representative text of you and your company.